Hello, besties. If you haven't noticed, I am almost always alone. Don't get me wrong, I do have friends and we hang out whenever we can, but 99% of the time I am just doing things by myself, which is fine. Honestly, I've just always grown up that way. I've always been very independent and just kind of doing my own thing. I also had severe social anxiety in school, so I didn't really have much friends, so I just got used to it. And today is no different. Still alone, still doing things by myself. But that's okay, we're gonna make a day out of it. I'm kind of bored, I don't really feel like sitting in my apartment, so I'm gonna go to the city and just wander around, walk around. There is a few places I wanna hit up, but otherwise I'm just gonna kind of wander around aimlessly and see where the day takes me. So let's pick out an outfit. I really have no idea what I want to wear. It's like overcast, but still warm, but like a little bit chilly at times. The weather is confusing me. So I feel like I wanna wear something with a layer that I can take off if I get too hot. I also feel like I kinda wanna wear something dark. I'm not feeling bright colors today. Actually, I have like this green eyeliner eyeshadow thing on, so I kind of want the rest of my outfit to be neutral. Maybe these gray pants? Maybe? Ooh. Maybe my black little shirt that I thrifted with the people at the bottom? Let's see if I can get this to work. Okay, I kind of like this. I like this top part. I don't think I'm vibing with the pants though. So maybe jeans? Okay, yeah. I like that better. That looks good. I think I also am just gonna keep my hair in this clip ponytail type thing because it's a little windy and my hair already annoys me as it is, so I want it out of my face. I lied a little bit. I never actually am alone because I always have this bitch with me, except when I have to leave her, like right now. Seriously though, why can't I bring her everywhere with me? Why can't I bring her into stores? They allow children into stores. I'm pretty sure she's better than any human child, just saying. Bye. Bye, stop giving me that look. Bye.
For some pet toys for Zoe because they have the best toys and they're pretty cheap too. Because Zoe deserves some new toys, you know? Y'all, my AirPod flew out of my ear in the middle of the crosswalk, in the middle of the intersection, and I had to look around and pick it up and find it. Very humbling experience.
Okay, I'm back, but I'm not even gonna lie, I am so sweaty right now. It is hotter than I thought it was outside, so I'm literally gonna shower before I talk to you. Give me one second. Okay, y'all, quick outfit change, shower, we're good. Anyway, let me show you what I got. First, you saw I stopped in Ulta. I got the same thing. It's the Ordinary Organic Cold Pressed Rosehip Seed Oil. This is what I do to do like my face massages or my gua sha. And I just go through it so quickly, so I decided to get two this time because it's quite a hike to Ulta. And then as I mentioned, I went to Marshall's to get some dog toys for Zoe. And she was already sniffing the bag. She could smell something. I'm telling you, Marshall's has the best dog toys and they're always like $10 and under. First, I got this little alligator one. It's like a really tough one. Oh my gosh, is that a new toy? Yeah. And then I got a little lamb chop. I've been wanting to get her one of these lamb chop toys. This one's more fluffy. She will probably tear this apart within a day, but she'll still have fun. That's okay. Another one. Look at her, she's so happy. And then I got her some bones to chew on for when I do leave for extended periods of time. She can like distract herself hopefully by chewing a bone. These are pupper nutter, peanut butter flavor bones, I don't know. So yes, just spoiling my child. And then I ran into Brandy Melville real quick, which I've been meaning to go to for a while because I really just needed little plain white baby tee just for like layering things. Also, I just needed like a new crisp white shirt. And I just love Brandy for basics. And then speaking of basics, I also got two tank tops, which I already own like three of these exact style tank tops. I just love them. They're the most perfect fitting tank top. You can probably tell in most of my videos, I just wear basic tank tops all the time, especially they're like higher neck and thick straps, and they're just the most flattering on me. So I've been eyeing this brown one for a while, so I got a brown one. And then I got another white one just because I wear my white one
every single week. Oh, and last second at checkout, I just got a black headband because I also just wanted and needed a headband. But yeah, really basic items, not the most exciting shopping spree. They're just kind of things that I needed. I did get myself a little treat though. I realized I didn't really eat lunch, which is weird because usually I'd be starving, especially since I was walking around so much. But I got myself a vegan whoopie pie. I don't know, I just passed a bakery and it said vegan on it. I'm like, oh, let's see what's in there. And there's this chocolate vanilla whoopie pie. And I was like, okay, I'll take it. So, I mean, it's delicious. And of course, some coffee. Even though I already had a coffee today, I tried not to drink two coffees a day. But it's been really hard recently. I fear I'm going too deep into an addiction of coffee. Oh, this is like the perfect combo that I need it.
Do you like your new toy?
Let's just see if she tears one of these open by the end of the day, because she probably will. Okay, besties, time for an actual meal. I'm making like a little poke bowl, rice and vegetables and stuff. I've made this before. It's one of my favorite meals, but just got some white rice, some cucumber and carrots, sliced up and marinated in soy sauce, sriracha, vinegar, sesame oil. I think that's it. Some tofu that I just cubed and cooked up, edamame, avocado. Even though this has a lot of ingredients, it's really just chopping them up. The only thing you really have to cook is the tofu, which takes like 5 minutes, and you can pre-cook your rice. I just usually keep rice cooked in the fridge. Then you top it off with some green onions, and I like to sprinkle some everything bagel seasoning. And look at that, you have a beautiful, colorful, veggie-filled, nutritious bowl. So, it's so good. It's like refreshing too, because all the ingredients minus the tofu, if you just cooked it, are cold. While we're here eating together, I wanted to continue the kind of talk about just doing things alone and doing things on my own all the time. So I've always been an extremely independent person. I'm the oldest sibling. I'm the only girl. I was the first one to get a job, go to college, move out. I'm the oldest of my friend group, so I'm the one that had like a lot of experiences first and then shared it with my friends. And I just have an extremely independent personality. Now, granted, I did again, struggle with really bad social anxiety, especially in high school and college, and I didn't really have many friends or that great of friends, so I just got used to being on my own. But that has changed. I now have a really, really great group of friends, and again, even though I don't see them like on an everyday basis, we're always there to talk to text, to FaceTime, whatever. So like, even though I am alone now, like physically, I never feel lonely anymore. Plus with just like getting older and actually like living on my own and doing things and having more life experience, I've just learned to become like my best friend. I enjoy spending time with myself. I'm just an introverted person. Social settings drain me. Like if I go out one day for the week, I need like a week to recover. I've definitely gotten better. I definitely like actually enjoy social settings now. Again, I just need like a period of rest between them, but I genuinely enjoy just doing things on my own. I think it's just very freeing. You don't have to worry about anyone else. You can just take your time with things. I've always like gone out to eat by myself and like take myself out to restaurants, and I've had like friends where people would be like, oh my god, I can never do that, like go to the restaurant alone. I'm like, almost every time I've been to a restaurant, I've been by myself. We all know I flew to Scotland and stayed there for 4 months on my own. I mean, I did stay with a friend, but flew across the ocean by myself. And I know there's a lot of people that struggle with like the opposite problem, where they don't like spending time with themselves, or they're not comfortable just doing things on their own, so they constantly need to surround themselves with people. And that's okay too, but I think you need to find a balance, because before I would isolate myself from people due to just like my hyper independence or my anxiety or my depression. And I found that having friends and being social actually helps in life and makes life better. Sometimes I do wonder though if like my hyper independence is cutting me off from some things. I don't really talk about relationships much, like at all, because truthfully, I don't have anything to say when it comes to like dating and romantic relationships and stuff. Simply because, again, I'm just so used to being by myself. I'm not even like seeking anything. Like, yeah, if I think about it too much, I'm like, maybe I should date or like try to find a significant other or something, but I'm not quite sure if I'm like missing out or not, and if I'm actually just like distancing myself from a relationship. That's something I actually like deep dive a lot and do a lot of self introspection about, because it really wasn't only until like the past 2 years where I found stable friendships. I just feel like I am moving at a lot slower pace than like the average person, where I need to establish being comfortable in friendships first and then becoming comfortable in like romantic relationships. So I guess the point of this little chat is just like, figure out what you're comfortable with and do things on your own time. There's no pressure to like hit certain milestones or do certain things. Societal standards are a scam. We know this, but I think it is really important to enjoy company with yourself, because at the end of the day, you're the only person you got. You're the only person you can truly count on and will never leave you. Okay, well, thanks for listening to my TED Talk. I'm gonna finish eating this.
What did I say? It's been 2 hours since I brought that home.
You having fun there, Zoe? Yeah?
I'm glad. Since it's so nice out, I decided to come to my rooftop, which I don't do enough. It's just not warm enough to, but this is the view we're working with. Of course, Zoe is joining me and her toy to keep her busy. And to keep me busy, I have the book I'm currently reading, which I did already read, but this time I'm annotating it, and my journal. So yeah, I'm just gonna chill up here for a bit and journal and read and just vibe, I guess.
Okay, besties, not gonna lie, I went too deep with my journaling and then I hurt my own feelings and then I got sad and then I sat on TikTok for about 2.5 hours and now it's almost midnight. It's okay, I'm fine now. I posted an emo TikTok and that got it out of my system. So, I'll see you tomorrow. Okay. Hello, besties. I have bright-ass red hair. I don't know how well the camera is picking it up. But, Little Mermaid is here, guys. So yeah, it's been a few days since I ended my last clip and I was home for the weekend. And then I also realized I really, really wanted my hair done, but no salons would get an appointment for me before I went on my trip in a week. So I was like, okay, guess I'm doing it myself then. No, I did not record it on video, but I did make a few TikToks about it. So check out my TikTok, but yeah, I don't really know how I did this. I'm just happy it turned out because I was getting scared. But now I'm successfully a redhead and I love it. Let's see if I can get better lighting. Like, she is bright, bright as fuck. This is what I wanted the first time, but it didn't work out. But we got it this time, so it's okay. And now I'm so excited because I can be a redhead in Ireland. Okay, so yeah, there's that. Hello, welcome to a new day. Today is yet another day of being alone in my apartment with Zoe. And I just gotta clean. Like I said, I was home for the weekend, so I was gone for a few days, and somehow I came home to a messy apartment. I don't even know. But I'm just gonna clean like I do every other day in every other vlog. But you guys like it, so let's go. You guys know the drill. I'm cleaning, therefore One Direction is playing. I would suggest Eternals in One Direction as well for this moment in time, and we can jam together. Like I said, I went home for the weekend, so I just have some like stuff to unpack. Whenever I go home, I need to stay like overnight, one day max, and I always stay for like 3 or 4 days. And by home, I mean Jersey, where I'm like from, where my family is. All my friends are there too. But I actually did stay because we had a service for my Grammy who passed this winter. So that was nice. Sad, sad day, but also happy day because I got to see family members I haven't seen in a while. So that's what I was home for. I had to pack many outfits because I didn't know what I was gonna wear, all this. I'm just like unpacking this stuff right now. I really like to think I'm low maintenance, and then I pack an overnight bag for supposed to be one night and I bring like a million things. So, which is funny because for my 3-week trip to Ireland, my friend and I are like, oh, you know what? Let's do the challenge of just packing a carry-on. Let's not get a checked bag. This would be the size of my carry-on for a 3-week trip. I can fill this for one night at my house. So I think I'm gonna need a checked bag. I also got two little things at Target that were so cute. First of all, this vest, which I don't own a vest. I've been wanting a vest though. And it's just like this pretty white and rainbow thread. Oh, and this is all wrinkly because it was sitting in the bag. But I just got a blue button up because I have my white button up and I love it. And I just wanted the classic blue one. Gives me summer vibes. And I thought these were really two good steals at Target. All right, let me put the rest of this away. I live for you, I long for you, Olivia.
Come and idolize the light in your eyes, Olivia. I live for you, I long for you, Olivia. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. What super thrilling and exciting thing I'm doing now, you have to be wondering. Editing a video. Actually, it's this video. Kind of crazy. This is literally what most of my days look like. Cleaning up after myself and editing stuff. I have nothing else to say. That's literally what I'm gonna be doing probably for the next hour. And then at night, I'll probably go to bed watching Gordon Ramsay's Hell's Kitchen. Maybe make a snack. We'll see. The world is my oyster. From my apartment. Bedroom. As of right now. What did I say? Snack and Gordon Ramsay. How I end most of my nights. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you have a wonderful day or night wherever you are. And make sure you stay tuned to my next video. Bye.